in the MiG 17. Over 9,000 MiGs were built, the MiG 17, and today you're going to witness a thunderous jet performance powered by the Klimov VK1 afterburning turbojet engine. It produces some 7,600 pounds of thrust while an afterburner. Now completing his takeoff checks, he's now on the roll. Ladies and gentlemen, we proudly present today's performance of Michael Turfer and the Soviet MiG 17. Going toe-to-toe with those F-4 Phantoms, F-105s, and other aircraft during Vietnam. 30-degree angle of wing sweep on this MiG-17 as Michael Turfer approaches once again from our left. This aircraft first took flight in 1950 and appeared in Soviet service in 1952 with five versions ultimately produced. It has served with air arms of nearly 30 nations around the world, including nations friendly and not so friendly to the United States. At over 450 miles an hour, here comes Mike Turfer and the MiG-17. Now, you might be asking, why in the world are we flying a Russian jet in American airspace? Well, at the end of the collapse of the Soviet Union, many nations began to liquidate anything that they could, including a variety of ex-military equipment. Many MiG-17s became available for purchase on the civilian market, and today are very popular jet warbirds. Simply put, it showcases the freedoms that we have to fly these airplanes in the United States of America. This aircraft, as I mentioned, one of the first in the world to feature an afterburner, which provides a whole lot more thrust, and it does so by dumping raw jet fuel into the exhaust, exploding out the tailpipe. Michael will now demonstrate this in this minimum radius turn, as shown. Turning airplanes anywhere in the world up until the F-16. We are now going to go up live to the cockpit with Michael Turfer. He's going to set up for a high-speed pass and see if we can talk to him on the radio. Michael, how do you copy?
Hello, Kentucky. You guys look beautiful today. And I'm just having an absolute top line for y'all today. The regulators have raised our speed limit today. What do you say we take this thing and see how fast we go?
Mike, that sounds good with us. Would you like to see him go fast, everybody? I think that's a yet, Mike. Yes, Mike, I think you're going to be setting up. You're going to be cruising in just under the speed of sound, right? 0.9-something Mach?
0.92, if we can get it up there.
Copy that. Well, I'll tell you what, we've got eyes on you to the left. How about you call the speeds for me as you make your way in?
Okay.
Dive it in. The Mikoyan Gurevich MiG 17, one of those feared aircraft during the 1960s.
All right, we're coming in now.
Copy that. We've got visual on you. What are we looking at speeds right now?
250 knots here, Rick. I got full power. Further now.
Copy that.
There goes the afterburner. There's 300 knots.
Folks in town certainly could hear that.
350. 400. 450. 500. 575. 0.92
Mach. That's 92% the speed of sound. Let's give it up for Mike Turfer in the MiG 17. All right, Mike, we'll let you continue with your routine. I know you got some more fuel to burn out there.
Thank you, sir. I'm going to show you one of those steep turns.
Copy that. We'll be looking for it. Earlier, we talked a little bit about Operation Half Drill and Half Donut, which were two classified missions during Vietnam that focused on the procurement of these MiG aircraft in the 60s. Our allies, the Israelis, acquired a MiG-21 and later a MiG-17. And they actually were able to provide that to the United States to allow us to... F-86 Sabre. We took our top pilots out of the Navy and the Air Force, and we actually flew a captured MiG-17. And time after time, they continued just to get waxed by the MiG-17. But those projects, an aircraft like this MiG-17, helped us transfer critical knowledge to our warfighters so our soldiers could come back home and have a higher attrition rate during Vietnam. That project later went on to help create the famed Navy's Weapons School, all otherwise known as Top Gun. At just a mere 320 miles an hour from the left, Michael Turfer and the MiG-17. Stage, raw jet fuel ignited, giving it a significant kick in the pants and significantly more thrust and power. Michael is no stranger to aviation, having flown corporate jets for 15 years and specializes in flight instruction. He holds an airline transport pilot certificate. He's a CFI as well and has flown a variety of aircraft, including Gulfstreams, Lear jets, MiG-17s, L-39s, and many others. From the right, at just 100 feet above the ground, here's the MiG-17. Today, and for the opportunity and invitation to showcase off the flying characteristics of this aircraft. For Michael, it is absolute freedom. He says thanks to all the veterans. As soon as Michael touches down out there on runway 23, he'll be taxied into the crowd. Have the opportunity to meet with Michael and get your picture alongside the MiG-17. On final approach, airspeed 120 miles an hour. Thank you. touchdown.